Welcome to this video lecture on novel. Now, the novel is the literary genre that is considered as the most modern literary forms. It is the longest genre of narrative prose fiction. It is considered to be a descendant of the medieval romances, and the term novel is believed to be derived from the word novella, the Italian term novella. There are various types of novels, like historical novels, there are sentimental novels, picaresque novels, epistolary novels, and so on.
The novel is the longest genre of narrative prose fiction. It has undergone many changes and developments over the years. Studying the history of the novel reveals the evolution of different forms of this genre. Now, it is considered the most modern of all literary forms. It is an extended prose narrative. And as I mentioned, the term is derived from novella, which means a little new thing. The novel is largely considered as a descendant of the medieval romances. In this video, we will be discussing a few major types of the novel form. The romance novel. This is the European form of the novel. It was primarily concerned with characters and events very remote from everyday life. Principally, a romance novel is just a form of entertainment. It contains ideal love, adventure, fantasy, heroic adventures, extravagance, the marvelous, and the mythic. It is extremely difficult to define a romance novel as it encompasses the diverse forms such as the medieval narrative poems, the gothic novels, and even modern Mills and Boone romances. The term romance loosely suggests a non-didactic narrative that deals with ideal love and heroic and spectacular achievements. An example of a medieval romance that was very popular in the 12th century is Sir Gawain and the Green Knight by an anonymous English author. Medieval chivalric romances were very popular. Such romances featured knights on a quest, damsels in distress, dragons, wizards, magic spells, tournaments, and so on. In these romances, the focus was on courtly love, an unrelenting pursuit of the love of a lady. The medieval chivalric romances were different from ordinary novels in their obsession with allegory and psychological exploration of characters rather than providing a social commentary. It was different from the epic in its focus on courtly love and not on war and heroism. Chivalric romances were often parodied in other works. The most famous chivalric romance in English is Sir Thomas Malory's Le Morte d'Arthur, written in the late 15th century. A similar form of medieval romance is the quest romance. The quest romance involves the journey of a hero on a quest that involved various trials, like fighting with enemies, temptation to abandon the quest for indulging in other pleasures like romances, and so on. The quest for the Holy Grail is a classic example of the quest romance. Homer's Odyssey is another example. The novel is said to be actually a rebellion against the excesses portrayed in the medieval romances. Now, the most important early novel is Miguel de Cervantes' Don Quixote. It mocked chivalry and romantic adventures, and it attempted to achieve a harmony between idealistic romance and harsh reality. Another type of novel is the picaresque novel. The term picaros is derived from the Spanish term picaro, which means rogue or rascal. In English, the term means a scoundrel of low birth and evil life at war with society. Now, this kind of novel is a genre of prose fiction that depicts the adventures of an unscrupulous person, a kind of anti-hero, who lives by his wits in a very dishonest society. The Picaros novel originated in Spain, and it helped to establish realism as the dominant trend in the Spanish novel. Cervantes has also incorporated elements of the Picaros. It was in the 16th century that the Picaros novel made its way into other European literatures. The first Picaros novel in England was Sir Thomas Nash's Unfortunate Traveller, or The Life of Jack Wilton. Other outstanding examples include Henry Fielding's Tom Jones and the American writer Mark Twain's The Adventures of Huckleberry Finn. The Picaro is a first-person narrator. The character can vary from a rather helpless, though clever, village idiot to a trickster who manipulates others with cruelty and finesse. The Picaro mostly has a tyrannical master from whom he escapes and learns more about life. The uncontrollable independence of the Picaro is juxtaposed with society's unchangeable resentment towards these characters who occupy the fringes in society. Often, the English Picaro's novels ended abruptly with the Picaro leaving for America or some other place to pursue a new life. The Picaro's novels are written in episodic narrative form, and it satirizes the individual and the society it depicts. The next important type of novel is the sentimental novel. The sentimental novel is a literary genre that was popular in 18th century England. The term in literature denotes the overuse of pathetic effects, superficial emotions, pretense, vain assumptions of sorrow, fake anguish, and attempts to arouse sympathy. It focused on the distresses of the virtuous and attempted to show that a sense of humor and moral behavior were rightly rewarded. The sentimental novel also tried to show that the display of unrestrained emotion is the true evidence of kindness and goodness in human beings. The conventions essential to the sentimental novel were Rousseau's doctrine of natural goodness of man and his belief that moral development was nurtured by experiencing powerful sympathies. In the 1760s, the sentimental novel developed into the novel of sensibility, which represented characters possessing a noticeable vulnerability to gentle feelings. Such characters were not only extremely moved by sympathy for their fellow beings, but also reacted passionately to the beauty in nature and art. Romanticism adopted many elements of the novel of sensibility, including sensitivity to nature and belief in the wisdom of the heart and in the power of sympathy. The classic example of a sentimental novel is Samuel Richardson's Pamela. Other important examples include Oliver Goldsmith's The Vicar of Wakefield, Henry Brooks' The Man of Feeling, and Sterne's A Sentimental Journey. Sentimentalism as a literary genre revealed the tendency for the luxury of grief. It constituted an excess or overindulgence in tender emotions such as pathos and sympathy. The next important type of novel is the epistolary novel. This is a novel form in which the story is narrated through the medium of letters written by one or more of the characters. The first epistolary novel in English is considered to be a translation from the French in 1678 called The Letters of a Portuguese Nun. Samuel Richardson's Pamela, or Virtue Rewarded, published in 1740, is considered to be a masterpiece in this genre. This is the story of a servant girl's victorious struggle against her master's attempts to seduce her. It was one of the earliest forms of the English novel to be developed and one of the most popular novels up to the 19th century. The epistolary novel's dependence on subjective points of view makes it the precursor of the modern psychological novel. The historical novel is a genre of prose fiction that has as its setting a specific period of history. It attempts to convey in a factual manner the manners, beliefs, socio-political and cultural conditions of that period realistically and faithfully. Therefore, it is considered closer to romance than realism. The work may deal with actual historical characters or it may portray a combination of fictional and historical characters. Historical characters can either be the protagonist or even minor characters. Historical novels may focus on a single historic event, but more often it attempts to portray naturalistically an accurate view of the past. The impact of historical events is reflected on the private lives of the characters, as in Charles Dickens' A Tale of Two Cities, published in 1859, which is set against the backdrop of the French Revolution. Since the appearance of the first English historical novel, which is Sir Walter Scott's Waverley Novels, published in 1814, this type of fiction has remained popular. Leo Tolstoy's War and Peace is of the highest artistic quality. It is a historical novel of the highest artistic quality. Critics have accused historical fiction writers of portraying history only in costumes and language and not depicting the outlook and beliefs of the people who lived during that age. Historical novels mostly portray contemporary attitudes and customs of the people. They attempt a study of the relationship between personal fortunes and social reality. During the mid-20th century, there was a revival of interest in this genre. The Gothic novel. The Goths were a northern European tribe that fought valiantly against the Roman Empire. The adjective Gothic signifies a monstrous and barbarous artistic style, deviating from the Greco-Roman tradition. As a literary genre, this form of medieval prose fiction that originated soon after the birth of the novel was striking for its dominant atmosphere of fantasy, mystery, and horror. It can be considered as a response to the meekness of the novel of manners and the novel of sensibility. The revival of interest in the Middle Ages paved the way for the popularity of Gothic fiction between the 1760s and the 1830s. The Gothic genre was introduced in England by Horace Walpole in his pioneering novel, The Castle of Otranto, published in 1765. He was followed by Anne Radcliffe with Her Mysteries of Udolpho in 1794. The traditional plot of a Gothic novel involves a beautiful heroine surrounded by dark shadows, strange noises, a candle that keeps blowing out, and it is usually set in a dilapidated building, usually a castle in medieval ruins, and the whole terrain would be claustrophobic. A more sensational type of Gothic romance exploiting horror and violence was introduced to England by Matthew Gregory Lewis with his Monk in 1796. Other landmarks of Gothic fiction include William Beckford's Oriental romance, Vathek, V-A-T-H-E-K, and Charles Robert Maturin's story of an Irish Faust named Melmoth the Wanderer. For the portrayal of Gothic settings, authors often drew inspiration from dilapidated castles or monasteries, underground passages, elemental passions, fear and struggle between rationality and imagination, and so on. Gothic novel critiqued the realism of the novel form. Radcliffe gave rational explanations for the horrors depicted in her works, but Horace Walpole did not. Jane Austen's Northanger Abbey parodied the Gothic novel. The early Gothic romances died of their own extravagances of plot, but Gothic machinery, the supernatural atmosphere, continued to haunt the fiction of major writers such as the Bronte sisters, Edgar Allan Poe, Nathaniel Hawthorne, and even Charles Dickens. Emily Bronte's Wuthering Heights is written in the Gothic tradition. Other writers include Daphne du Maurier, Mary Wollstonecraft, and Bram Stoker. They are considered Gothic fiction as they are set in grotesque and claustrophobic terrain and introduce the existential nature of humankind as its definitive mystery and terror. In the second half of the 20th century, the term was also applied to describe paperback romances depicting similar themes and symbols used in the original Gothic novels. So with this, we come to an end of this video lecture. Stay tuned to another video that will discuss other more different types of the novel genre. So thank you so much for your patient listening. Stay home and stay safe.